Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome to another edition of Gervonta's Sexuals Gone Wild. And look, let's break it down honestly and objectively as possible. And you know, we start with the first dummy of the day is Canary Kane. And he states, nobody wants to accept Tank Davis's challenges. Get out of here, boy. LOL. He tried to fight everybody. And also, Tank beats lots of undefeated fighters. Now, basically what he's saying is Tank, you know, he's a guy that's offering fights to all these fighters, and no one wants to accept his challenges. He also states that he's tried to fight everybody. So basically, he's saying the whole world is ducking Tank Davis. Tank is not ducking anybody. Everybody's ducking Tank Davis. Now, the interesting thing about this statement is it makes no sense. It's clear Tank Davis has been running from Vasyl Lomachenko for years. For years, Tank Davis has been running from him. Lomachenko never got an offer to fight Tank Davis. Never, not one. So how did he try to fight him? And how did he not accept Tank challenge? See, make it make sense. You truly can't fix stupid. Not only that, how did Tank Davis try to fight Josh Taylor? A Josh Taylor who said he would beat up and destroy Tank Davis. How did he try to fight him? What was his offer? What was that? He never tried to fight Josh Taylor. He never tried to fight Vasyl Lomachenko. So my question goes back to Canary Kane. Why would a grown man come out and out of his own mouth say the stupidest thing I've ever heard? This is a guy that's literally hugging Tank Davis's meat. Canary Kane, you need to let that boy meat go. But let's keep it going. Izzo, the truth, basically states Tank Davis has called out Teofimo Lopez. Teofimo's all talk, but yet he hiding his belts for years now. Ever since he was getting worked by a 126-pounder in Lomachenko, Teofimo can't even sell tickets. And you're on your knees for Teofimo. So basically, Izzo, the truth, is saying, you know, we're all overrating Teofimo Lopez. Because, you know, at the end of the day, Tank called out Teofimo, so that means he wants to fight. Tank has called out a lot of people, and he's run from those same people he's called out. But the funny thing is, he says Teofimo's all talk, yet he's hiding his belts for years now. And then he said he was getting worked by Vasyl Lomachenko, the same Lomachenko that Tank wouldn't fight. This guy's an absolute idiot. The funny thing is, when it came down to it and Tank Davis was going to be free, and it was anticipating after T.O. fights Kambosos, they asked Leonard Ellerbe, hey, is that a fight we could get? You know, Teofimo versus Tank? And he was basically saying, hell no, not that clown. He's not even interested in negotiating, talking about it, nothing. He wants no part of Teofimo because he knows Teofimo sends Tank Davis straight to hell. And not only that, we've already seen this set up. You can't deny it because Floyd Mayweather has already come out and stated that they're going to keep Tank Davis fights in-house. In-house. That means you're not going to see the Josh Taylor. You're not going to see the Teofimo. You're not going to see the Devin Haney. And you're not even going to see the Ryan Garcia. They are not letting him fight anybody that is not on Mayweather Promotions. Because all of those fighters do not fight on Mayweather Promotions. So Tank Davis is going to keep getting, you know, highlight reel knockouts of grocery store clerks, garage attendants, you know, pool boys. He's going to keep looking like a killer fighting my grandma. See, at the end of the day, you got to separate facts from feelings. Now, Izzo the Truth, it bothers me that somebody like Izzo the Truth would come out here and defend a grown man for no reason. He sounds like he just wants his cheeks clapped by Tank. Because men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.